Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Mrs. Bushra Mushtaq, PG Psychiatric Nursing. Today I am with the part 3rd of the previous video, that is sexual and identity disorder. Today I will be covering the topics like sexual response cycle and types of sexual dysfunctions. Before going to the sexual dysfunctions, let's talk about the sexual response cycle, the normal sexual response cycle. The sexual response cycle basically comprises of the 4 phases: the desire phase, excitement phase, orgasm phase, and resolution phase. Because the sexual dysfunctions, they occur as the disturbance in any of these phases of the sexual response cycle, so basically we should get a review about the normal sexual response cycle, and then you can understand, you know, the anatomy and the physiology of the prerequisites to consider the pathology and the treatment of these sexual dysfunctions. The first phase, the desire phase. During this phase, the desire, there is a desire to have sexual activity. And how this desire occurs? It can occur in response to any verbal, any physical, or any visual stimulation. And sexual fantasies can also sometimes bring the desire in this. It is the first phase in the normal sexual response cycle. The second phase is the excitement phase, and in this phase, the sexual arousal, there is a sexual arousal and a sort of the pleasure. We can call, we can say the erotic pleasure, and there are certain physiological changes which occurs both in the males and the females. Male responds to the erection, and the female changes or include the vasocongestion in the pelvis, vaginal lubrications, or sort of swelling in the external genitalia. It happens in the excitement phase. Then comes the third phase, which is the orgasm phase. It is orgasm, as you know, it is identified as a peak of the sexual pleasure, and there are the release of the sexual tension and the rhythmic contractions in the perineal muscles or the reproductive organs. And if we talk about the orgasm in the female, the women, it is marked by the stimulation, rhythmic contractions of the uterus and the lower third of the vagina, or may also occur in the anal sphincter also. And in males, this orgasm is responded by the forceful emission of the semen and response to the rhythmic spasm of prostate, or whether it be seminal vessels or vas or urethra. And the fourth phase is the resolution phase. And if the orgasm phase has occurred, then the resolution occurs, and this phase is characterized by disgorgement of the blood from the genitalia, because rush of the blood comes in the genitalia during the orgasm phase in both males and the females, and then in the resolution it subsides, creating a sense of general relaxation and the well-being. And if sometimes the orgasm is not achieved, the resolution phase may take various several hours, which may produce some sort of the pelvic discomfort and the feeling of the irritability also. So it was a quick review about the sexual sexual response cycle. Now coming to the types of the sexual dysfunctions, there are various types of the sexual dysfunctions according to the DSM-5 I'm talking about, like the erectile disorder, female orgasm disorder, delayed ejaculation, premature or early ejaculation, female sexual interest or arousal disorder, male hypoactive sexual desire disorder, genitopelvic pain, penetration disorder, and substance medication induces sexual disorders. These are very much easy to understand and not that sort of way complicated. The first one, the erectile disorder. As the word will indicate what type of disorder is this. In this erectile disorder, this disorder is characterized by marked difficulty in obtaining, either obtaining or maintaining the erection during the sexual activity, right? And there also there is the, you know, decrease in the erectile rigidity that may interfere with the sexual activity also, because we have just read about the normal sexual response cycle, how the erection comes and in which phase it comes, like the excitement phase. So it is important, but in the erectile disorder there is the difficulty in obtaining or maintaining this erection during the sexual activity. The problem has and this problem, it should persist for at least about 6 months and cause the individual significant distress, definitely. And there are also the two types of the we can say the primary erectile disorder and the secondary erectile disorder. The primary erectile disorder may the word may indicate that it refers to the cases in which the man has never been able to have any intercourse, and there is never is being used. He has never achieved the this erectile during the sexual activity, so he has never been able to have intercourse. And secondary erectile disorder refers to any cases in which the man has difficulty in getting or maintaining this erection during the sexual activity, but maintaining the erectility, but has been able to have vaginal intercourse at least once. At least he has gone for that, then the disorder has occurred. But in primary, he has never achieved this erectile activity during the sexual intercourse. The second is the female organs of disorder. The words will indicate here what type of disorder this is, that the female has never reached the orgasmic phase of the normal sexual response cycle, right? So in this female organism disorder, we can see there is a marked delay, or there is infrequency, or there is the absence of orgasm during the sexual activity. Yes, and during the any sexual activity. And it also may be characterized by the reduced intensity of orgasmic sensations. Taken up, there is reduced, you know, intensity of orgasmic sensations in the females in this type of disorder. And the condition, which is sometimes referred to as anorgasmia, because she has never, you know, there is a reduced or never achieved the intensity of orgasm sensation jo honi chahiye in the normal response cycle, but this female has never achieved this stage. So it can be also a condition called as the anorgasmia. And same, the disorder has lasted at least for 6 months and caused the individual with a significant distress. And the women who have jinko ye achieve who can achieve this orgasm through non-coital for example stimulation, but they are not able to experience it during the what is called as coitus in absence of the manual stimulation, and not necessarily categorized as the an orgasmic. Yeah, basically agar hum baat karenge, a woman jisko who is considered to have this primary orgasmic disorder, when she has never experienced orgasm by any kind of stimulation, theek hai na, chahe wo manual stimulation or the what is called as the by any through other stimulations as well, उसने कभी अचीव नहीं किया होगा ऑर्गेजम फेज, तो उसको हम प्राइमरी ऑर्गेजमिक डिसऑर्डर में रखते हैं. एंड इन द सेकेंडरी ऑर्गेजमिक डिसऑर्डर एग्जिस्ट्स इफ दिस वूमेन हैज़ अचीव्ड एट लीस्ट वंस orgasm, and regardless of the means of stimulation, chahe manual or any type of other, but no longer ab wo matlab ab usko orgasm phase achieve nahi ho raha hai, but she is not no longer does so having the orgasmic phase of the stimulation. So this was about the female orgasmic disorder. Let me just confine it. It is the disorder of the females where she has never or we can say delayed or infrequency or absence of the orgasm during the sexual activity. And they can be also the primary and the secondary orgasmic disorders. The next one is the delayed ejaculation. Delayed ejaculation is also characterized by the marked delay in ejaculation or infrequency, we can say. Infrequency matlab frequency jab zarurat hogi ejaculation ki, but there is no ejaculation, infrequency hai. And for example, two times zarurat hai ya two times he should ejaculate, he doesn't. Or there is the absence of the ejaculation during the partner's sexual activity. That is called as delayed ejaculation. And this condition as the same, it has lasted for 6 months and causes the individual a significant distress. And with this disorder, the man is unable to ejaculate. Yes. Even though he has good this firm erection, or he has had more than adequate stimulation, but he is not able to ejaculate. And the severity of the problem, it may range from only occasional problems of ejaculation, jisko hum secondary bolte hain, matlab occasionally wo kabhi kabhi ejaculate nahi karta hai, but to a history where he has never experienced this ejaculation, which is the primary disorder, where he has never experienced this ejaculation, experienced an orgasm. And in the most common version, the man cannot ejaculate during coitus, but may be able to ejaculate as a result of any type of other stimulations. ठीक है ना, कभी कभी main जो ये manual stimulation से क्या उसको बोलते हैं वो main coitus से वो ejaculate नहीं कर सकता है, but with the other stimulations he may ejaculate that time. This is called as delayed ejaculation. Next is the premature or early ejaculation, where it describes the premature or early ejaculation as persistent, we can say, or a recurrent ejaculation occurring within 1 minute of the beginning of partnered sexual activity and before the person wishes it. So there is ejaculation, but it is premature. Within 1 minute of the sexual activity, or what is called as before the person wishes ejaculation ho, usse pehle hi ho jati hai. That's why the name indicates here the premature ejaculation. And in the same, this lasts for about 6 months, and there occurs significant distress in the individual. And the diagnosis should take into account the factors which will affect the duration of the excitement phase also, because kabhi kabhi excitement phase bahut lamba jata hai because of the man's age, because of the person's age, ya uniqueness of the sexual partner is there, ya frequency of the sexual activity kitne baar ho rahi hai, kitne frequency se sexual activity hoti hai, uska asar bhi ejaculation pe padega. And what is called as premature or early ejaculation, it is the most common sexual disorder and for which they seek the treatment. And it is particularly common among young men who have a very high sex desire and have not yet learned to control their ejaculations. Next is the female sexual interest or arousal disorder. This disorder, it is characterized by reduced or absent interest. Kyunki yahan pe sexual interest ki baat ho rahi hai aur arousal ki baat ho rahi hai, to female ko reduced sexual reduced hoga ya totally absent hoga interest, theek hai na, in sexual activity. or in the pleasure in sexual activity. And this individual typically does not initiate any, obviously jab usko koi interest nahi hai, she will not initiate any sexual activity, and you know, and she is commonly unreceptive to the partner's attempts to initiate. Matlab, she herself, you know, actively does not participate in any sort of sexual activity. And there is an absence of the sexual, you know, thoughts, fantasies. Usko kabhi aayenge nahi ya erotic cues nahi aayenge, jiski wajah se arousal bhi nahi hoga. Aur jab usko interest nahi hai, obviously arousal nahi hoga. Aur ye condition bhi 6 months tak rehni चाहिए persistent, which will cause the individual the significant distress. This is the female sexual interest or arousal disorder. Next comes the male hypoactive sexual desire disorder. It is the male disorder in which there is the persistent or recurrent deficiency or absence of sexual fantasies, same, and the desire for the sexual activities. ये male वाला है जिसको बहुत कम sexual desires होते हैं, या तो बहुत कम, दैट इज़ डिफिशेंसी होती है, या तो एब्सेंसी होती है सेक्चुअल फैंटसीज की, या डिज़ायर फॉर सेक्चुअल एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ सेक्चुअल एक्टिविटी. एंड व्हाट क्या इसको बोलते हैं, ये भी कंसिडर किया जाता है कि इन मेकिंग द जजमेंट्स वेदर अ मेल इज़ हैविंग दिस टाइप ऑफ डिसऑर्डर, देर आर वेरियस यू नो थिंग्स विच आर टू बी कंसिडर्ड, लाइक सच एज एज, सर्कमस्टेंसेज ऑफ द पार्टनर्स लाइफ, ऐसा कुछ. तो उसकी वजह से भी डिज़ायर कम हो सकता है इन मेल्स में, और दे हैव डेफिशिएंट इन द सेक्चुअल फैंटसीज. एंड द एनी इंडिविजुअल जिसको एब्सोल्युटली लेवल ऑफ द सेक्चुअल डिज़ायर मे नॉट बी द प्रॉब्लम, रादर द प्रॉब्लम मे बी द डिस्क्रिपेंसी बिटवीन द पार्टनर्स लेवल. कभी कभी ऐसा भी होता है. और क्या इसको बोलते हैं, बिफोर गोइंग टू एनी पैथोलॉजिकल इवेंट्स कि इसको इंटरनल कोई प्रॉब्लम या रिप्रोडक्टिव कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, वी शुड कंसिडर फॉर द पार्टनर्स हिस्ट्री एज वेल एज द एज ऑफ द और द स्ट्रेस लेवल्स इन द मेल्स, जिसकी वजह से ये मेल हाइपोएक्टिव सेक्सुअल डिजायर डिसऑर्डर हो सकता है. नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू द जेनिटो पैल्विक पेन और पेनिट्रेशन डिसऑर्डर, ये वर्ड ही इंडिकेट करता है दैट देयर इज़ अ पैल्विक पेन और जेनिटल पेन ड्यूरिंग द पेनिट्रेशन. सो द इंडिविजुअल्स विद दिस डिसऑर्डर एक्सपीरियंसेस कंसिडरेबल डिफिकल्टी, वी कैन से, और कंसिडरेबल यू नो डिफिकल्टी विद द वेजाइनल इंटरकोर्स एंड अटेम्प्ट्स एट पेनिट्रेशन. एंड पेन इज फेल्ट यू नो इन द वेजाइना और द वेजाइनल एंट्रेंस और द क्लिटोरिस type, या deep pelvic pain भी होती है. and there is fear, there is anxiety associated with the anticipation of the pain also, because once she has experienced this sort of pain and then the next time there is automatically the fear होगा, anxiety होगी उसको, अब क्या इसको बोलते हैं, anticipation ही होगी pain की और द वजाइनल पेनिट्रेशन. एंड देर बेसिकली क्या होता है, वहाँ पे टेंसिंग एंड टाइटनिंग ऑफ पेल्विक फ्लोर मसल्स हो जाता है ड्यूरिंग ही वो जब वो अटेम्प्ट करती है फॉर द पेनिट्रेशन. देर ऑकर्स द वजाइनल एंड टेंसिंग एंड द टाइटनिंग ऑफ द पेल्विक फ्लोर मसल्स. एंड दिस डिसऑर्डर, दिस कंडीशन मे बी लाइफ लॉन्ग क्या उसको बोलते हैं, या मतलब परसिस्टेंट सिंस द इंडिविजुअल बिकम सेक्चुअली एक्टिव, या तो लाइफ लॉन्ग होगी पहले से ही उसको ये पेन जब से वो एक्टिव हुई होगी सेक्चुअली, या एक्वायर्ड मतलब बिगिन आफ्टर अ पीरियड ऑफ रिलेटिवली नॉर्मल सेक्चुअल फंक्शंस. और ये डिसऑर्डर भी 6 months तक एटलीस्ट परसिस्टेंट होना चाहिए एंड कॉज द इंडिविजुअल क्लिनिकली सिग्निफिकेंट डिस्ट्रेस. The next and the last one is the substance or medication induced sexual dysfunction. So here you clearly will get that this dysfunction occurs or develops after the individual has used any substance, any medication, and there is any substance intoxication or withdrawal after the exposure to any sort of the medications. And this dysfunction may involve pain, it may also involve some impaired desires, impaired arousals, impaired orgasm, कुछ भी हो सकता है इनमें. एंड सम सबस्टेंसेज या मेडिकेशंस दैट दैट वेरी मच इंटरफेयर विद द सेक्चुअल दिस फंक्शनिंग, वो हो सकते हैं अल्कोहल, एम्फेटामाइंस, कोकीन, ओपियोइड्स या हिप्नोटिक्स या एंजोलेटिक्स या एंटी डिप्रेसेंट्स, इवन एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव्स या कुछ अदर ड्रग्स भी जो इंडिविजुअल यूज़ करता है उसकी वजह से भी सेक्चुअल या मेडिकेशन इंड्यूसेस सेक्चुअल डिसफंक्शंस हो सकते हैं. That was all about today's topic. I'll continue with the part 4th of the video soon, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.